graph the data. So 0, 4, of course that's 0 for x, 4 for y, 1, 8, 2, 12, 3, 16. Is it linear or non-linear? How do we know it's linear? Every time x goes up by 1, y goes up by 4. Right? That's a good exact answer, because what if I just said, oh, it looks like a line? Yeah, that's true. If it is definitely 100% a line, then it's a linear function. That's kind of why we call them linear functions. But what if I just said it looks like a line, so it's linear?
Not true.
What would be your argument against that?
I actually don't know.
And notice what I'm saying. I'm not saying it is a line. I'm saying it looks like a line.
Well, you'd have to draw a straight line to see if it's true.
You gotta make sure, for sure. Definitely for sure. The straight line can go through all of them, because what if a straight line could go all three of these, but then it actually would miss that one?
Well, I'd be wrong.
It wouldn't be a line. So to be sure that a line would go through them, we have to check, like Aiden said. Every time x goes over by 1, does y go up by the same amount for every pair of points? So x goes up by 1, y goes up by 4, 1, 4, 1, 4. Yeah. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Number 16. So it starts out with x pounds, y dollars. 2 pounds, it costs $2.80. This is pounds of sunflower seeds. For 3 pounds, we don't know how much it costs. And for 4 pounds, it costs $5.60. So, how much does 3 pounds cost is the question. And how did you figure that out? Richard?
I did $5.60 minus $2.80. And then that got me 2.8. And then I think I added 1.4, I don't remember. Oh, it's because I split 2.8 in half.
So we go up by $2.80 while we all go up by 2 pounds. So divide that change in $2.80 by the change of 2 pounds.
Uh-huh.
We come up with a nice 1.4, $1.40.
And then add that on to 2.8.
And add $1.40. Gives us 4.2. Question? So you added them together and divided by 2, okay? So what's that called? When you add two numbers together and then you divide by 2?
Average.
You find the average. And that, it works because that's right in the middle of these two. And if it's linear, it's exactly what we're looking for, the average of the two. If you add them together and divide by 2, you'll get the average is 4.2. So find the rate of change and add the rate of change on. Or just say, well, that's smack in the middle of these two pieces of data. So let's just find what's right in between them, what's halfway between those.
I just took two. I just divided like. I took 2.80 divided by 2, that got 1.4.
Okay, that's turns out to work okay, except for what you're assuming.
And then I did 4 divided by 5.68.
So you checked it.
Yeah.
So good if. And this only works, still, it only works if at x is 0, we get y is 0. For this function, it just so happens that we do. Maybe it just takes understanding the problem. The problem is we're buying sunflower seeds at so many dollars per pound. So if I buy 0 pounds, it should cost
$0.
Why would it cost me more than 0 to buy 0 pounds, right? So is that what you were thinking? We're buying sunflower seeds so many per pound, so $0, 0 pounds. So 2 pounds costing 2.80, I must be able to take 2.80 divided by 2, and I'll get how many per pound. And same reasoning, I should be able to take 5.60 divided by 4, get the same per pound. If there was some other value that started with at 0, then that wouldn't work. But it does for this one. So generally, I would recommend either either suggested or what Sarah suggested, dividing what's between those two. For those approaches, it doesn't matter that you got me at 0 pounds. It would still figure out what the rate of change is or what value. why it was right between those two.
Economy.
Alright, so that was part A, finding a missing piece. The linear function represents the cost y and x pounds of seeds.
Did you get it all?
Okay, it has to come up with y equals 1.4x. Initial value. Initial value means if we back up to x is 0, then what is y? Well, y is 0. Y is less than y. Is there a maximum to this function? Does it max out somewhere, just not be able to increase at all?
No.
Why not, Bridger?
No budget.
We don't have a budget, so to this function itself doesn't have a maximum. There's no budget mentioned. There's
right.
No limit to how many pounds can be purchased, right? Nothing is said about that, so we can just conceivably buy as many pounds as you want and spend as many dollars as you want.
That sounds fun.
Right, so no max. We can just buy as much as we want. Right, let's get a piece of paper, calculator, pencil, wait. If this is an example of a linear function, then what will we see?
A line.
Constant rate of change.
Constant rate of change. Yes. So is the rate of change constant? Let's find out. Well, let's look at the x's first. The x's are going up by, there we are. Goes up by 6, up by
6.
6 again.
6.
6 again. Could this, you know, would it throw everything off? But I know that it's not linear if this went up by 3?
No.
No. But the change in y had better follow suit, right? It had better change as well. Let's see. Well, it all changes by 6, so the y's should all change by, whatever changes by, it should be the same every time. So this goes down by?
5.
This goes down by?
5.
This goes down by?
5.
So?
It is.
Yes. It's linear. Well, I guess we shouldn't say yes. This is a linear. Tell whether, yeah. Finding the missing value, a couple of different approaches we learned today. We could find the rate of change that we would have in order for this to work, or we could find the average between these two. Finding the average is pretty easy. 20 plus 12, 32 over, 16,
2.
Yeah, 2. Because it's like two changes.
Oh, I got that.
16. So 16. Okay. If we go the other way, we find the rate of change. It's linear. You know, the funny thing about it, well, it is important. If this goes down by 7, and this goes down by 7, it's important because if these went down by different amounts, we could still do this, but it would be a little more challenging. But they do happen to go down by 7, so the average approach works. Finding the rate of change would work, right? So this goes down by a total of 14. This goes up by how much?
8.
By 8. Okay. So y changes 8. X changes 14, but it's negative. Y is going up, x is going down. We can simplify that to 4 over 7. So every time it goes down by 7, it should go up by 4. 12 plus 4. Also gives us 16. Alright, any questions?
Oh, here's another one. Sarah was gone.
Come on, Kyle.
No, this was Sarah's.
I had a rabbit, right? to help Sarah out.
Jeez, Kyle.
Yeah. Oh,
that's your bad, Kyle.
Yeah, man.
All right, we got our notes out because I want you to do something individually in your notes without talking, without giving away the answer. All right, and we're going to compare approaches. So it's all there, all the information you need, but I will go through real quick verbally. This is an amphitheater. Do you know what an amphitheater is?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
That stage there, you got your seats kind of, it would almost look like a staircase, like a giant staircase, and it's rounded, okay? I think this is all for acoustics, because you do this in kind of a shell or something back here reflecting sound out of the amphitheater. Anyhow, row one can see 12 people, row two, 15 people, row three, 18 people. The question is, if we keep following this pattern, I want you to shout it out. Row 23.
22, you said 22.
Oh, row 23.
You're welcome.
Two, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
No one even getting
it. All right, I'm going to write up here what I see several people doing, okay? It's not good or bad, it's just, well, it's good if you're doing it. It's bad if you're not doing anything. So, row one has room enough for 12, right? 12. Row two, 15 people. Row three, 18 people. So we just keep going. 4, 21, right? What, how much are we adding each time?
Three.
So the fact that you're adding three is probably the first thing that you notice.
Yeah.
Okay, so like we'll put our first thoughts are plus three. We add three every time. Okay, so we'll go to row five, that's going to be 24. Row six, that's going to be 27. Row seven, that's going to be 30.
There's an easier way.
So if you did that, will it work?
Yeah.
Of course it will. Ridiculous
question.
So we go to row 23. What happens if we want to go to like,
just 60.
Entertain the idea without saying that it probably isn't going to be the case? You.
Me?
Entertain the idea that maybe we want to go to row like 200.
That's not good. That's not good.
Wait, wait. Do we want to do this?
Yes.
No.
Do we want to go to row 200?
Yeah.
No, we do not want to do this.
Okay, there's a faster way. Of course, there's a faster way.
It's 6:12 to see the number.
Nope.
Let's just chill out for a second. Let's build our way up to that. All right. Let's say we start with the 12 people that can sit in the first row. I'm just gonna kind of recreate what's going on here, but in
I could have just easily done that.
I didn't just say simple mathematical computation.
High school student, he received a 4.0 GPA for semester one and did not get an invitation to the luncheon.
All right, I better go. I got a 4.0
in high school. Pretty good.
Yeah, I know. I'm
stuck. He's supposed to be
I am the man of the year.
Think about what you guys are doing to yourselves
yeah,
right now. You're wasting your time. Well. Certainly why we come to school. Have a good time.
Oh,
but they might as well change the sign outside to say Florence Carlton, have a good time.
Let's do
it!
It's
Floor
Town. That's already a lot of money.
It's Flow
Town.
Yeah, we don't have that kind of money.
Just out of respect for people who do understand what school is for, please stop wasting their time. Thank you.
Yeah, Mom.
So, if we start with the 12 people that can sit in the first row, and we add three people. We figure out how many people can sit in which row?
Second row.
Okay, so that's 15, right?
Yeah.
I could add three to that. And find out how many people sit in row?
Three.
Oh my lord.
I can add three to that. How many people sit in row?
Four.
Okay, but?
Four, you can do this.
Hold on. Exponent.
I know what to do, dude.
Exponent?
No.
Oh, you don't need this.
Yeah. Oh,
but Oliver got the right idea. He's trying to speed this up, right?
Yeah.
You just take 3 times 22.
3 times 22?
And then add 12 to it.
Why 22? It's row 23 we want to get to.
Oh. I mean, row 23.
No.
12
is the first.
Oh,
22,
and then you add 12 to it.
Oh, that's 12 is the first
row. All right, with a little more calmness, maybe you can explain.
Okay, because you, with 12, you already had the first row.
Yeah, first row.
So you just go ahead and yeah.
Oh my, I
so
just
when
said
add,
that.
When you add 3, you're on the, you're on the second row.
Just be quiet.
And if you add another 3, you're on the third row.
Yeah.
Yeah, so like, just to be clear, these 3 threes, if I add them on, I've added 3 threes, but I'm on row four.
Four.
Okay. So 12 plus 3 times what, Tyler?
22.
22. Because as Clint said, we started on row 1. So to get to row 23, we only have to go up 22 more. Okay? Move up, we got to add 3 22 times.
That makes sense. What I was going to do after I figured it out, since there's already 3 rows and you asked for 23 rows. One second.
Jesus.
You started at row 3.
So I started at row 3, and since there's already 18, then I did 3 times 10, since that equaled 30, and there was 2 rows, there's 2 of the 10s, so I added those 2 plus the 18.
So 18. Tyler. So then you added on 3 times?
3 times 10.
3 times 10?
No, 20.
20. Because at row 3, notice he's starting at row 3, I have to go up 20 rows, or steps, or whatever, to get to row 23. So that was 2. Both of those give us what? How many?
78.
78 people sitting in row 23.
Well, you're wrong.
Yeah, that'd be wrong.
No, it wouldn't. It'd be 78 people sitting in the flipping seats.
It'd be 60 plus 18.
It'd be 66, or you could do 66 plus 12. Like I said,
that would probably.
You
want to
say something?
Yeah,
you said I'm saying the same thing, so I said the same thing first.
Well, this is 12 plus 66, that's 78. 18 plus 60, that's 78. 78, we have to do it at the same time. Did you skip a row? 3, 4, 5.
I got 79. You got 79. You're wrong.
Because there is.
22, you missed row 22. Okay. So 78. Now we all agree. 78 people in row 23.
Yeah.
I really don't want to. I try to do everything I can for you, but you do so much against yourself.
I didn't know what I'm doing.
We weren't talking about you.
Other people.
We were just about the class.
Yeah. That seems likely. Okay, so 78 for row 23. How about for row whatever we want, row X?
So it's just basically a function.
It is a function. It's a function that's got a discrete domain, right?
Right.
Because it's row numbers, row number 1, 2, 3, 4. Not row number 1.7, that's not a thing that could happen.
3x plus 2.
You actually could.
3x plus 4.
Whoa. Where'd that come from? 3x plus 9.
Why are you doing that?
9.
Wouldn't it be 12?
Look back up to the.
0! Row 0!
Row 0.
Oh, we have row 0.
We could.
And it seats 0 people.
Okay, so there. See, would it seat 9 people?
Yeah,
well,
9.
But it's
9.
It's
9.
It'd be
9.
Because
0,
because
0 equals 9.
No, there's no such thing as 0 is 0.
Yeah, there
there's
is.
No,
we have to force it to work.
Yeah.
Because the logic makes sense.
Floor.
So this is, I don't know, they're standing on the floor.
Can we make this magical sign that says only use 9 if you use something for X?
Only use 9 if you use something for X?
Other than anything but 0 for X, then you can use 9.
Yes, you can.
Well, you can use 9 even if you do use 0. 3 times 0 is 0 plus 9.
So, like, do they have a sign table? Because then that would be
a sign? Where? At the amphitheater?
Wait, so if you said 3 times 23
okay,
plus 9,
this is
the
sign that says
we're getting off track!
Thank you, Grace.
No, we're kind of going on
track. Talking about.
Wait, so if you said.
Some of us are going like this, and others of you are just running around like this. As we're kind of going that way, you just chill out.
So if we did 3 times.
Do you
want
to learn this whole entire thing?
Yeah, I do actually. That's why I'm asking questions.
So if we did 3 times 23.
Yeah, if there's 23 rows, and then when we just had 9.
Well, let's try. We know it should be 78, right?
Yeah.
3 times 23 is
69
plus 9.
78.
78.
I knew it.
Oh, why are you so smart?
We used several approaches here. We started at row 1, Okay, Bridger started row 3 on this one. Here we just start on row 0. What if we did start on row 1? What would that formula look like? It would, well, it would look like 18 plus 3 times what?
Times 0.
Times 0? That's the formula? Just always 22. Multiply by 0?
No, never mind, not 0.
22
would
always be 18.
Okay, 22 for row 23, but what about row X?
But what do we know? There,
X.
We don't
if
know
I start at row 1, if I start at row 1, and I get, when I get to row X, will it take X steps to get there?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, now we're counting by steps? I thought we were counting the people in.
Well, with steps, rows, it's all the same.
Okay.
Would we have to walk up X rows to get to row X from row 1?
Yeah.
Let's back up to row 23. Do I have to, starting at row 1, do I have to step up 23 rows to get to row 23?
No. Well, it depends how big it is. No, you have
to
step up 23.
It'd be 22 steps.
22 steps, not 23 steps.
Oh, yeah.
What if we were going
up
to row 45? How many steps? 44 steps. What if we go up to row X?
Then it'd be Y.
X. Sex.
Oh, I don't know how we can make this work.
Why?
We can go, okay, go to the next page.
Next page.
Oh.
You can go. Okay. So
about
18, Y 18, equals
12.
12 plus 3. Wait, no, you don't know. X? Okay. Erase that 3.
Erase that 3.
Plus X, 3X.
Plus 3X?
Yeah. Minus 3.
Okay, that's the same as having 3x plus 9, and that's 100% correct. Because, like, just kind of like, let's fix it.
Yeah.
Minus 3. What about if I'm thinking 3 times the number of steps it takes to get to row x from row 1?
Minus 3.
X.
Somebody already said it.
Minus
1.
That's what I said.
I said that thing very much.
Always one less than the number of rows. If we start at row 1. Okay? All right. Well, what you guys have done is you have, at least we have together, really dismantled a thing called...
functions.
We can make a function to describe what it is, but what this is called, since it does, like, go one by one by one, like row 1, row 2, row
3.
And there's no row 2.5, right?
That'd be cool.
So we just see these numbers follow in sequence. So we're just following in sequence. Well, it's not steps like a step function. It's more like a dot, and then we skip a bunch, and there's no dots, and then there's another dot, and then we skip, and there's a bunch of no dots, and then another dot.
Mm-hmm.
It's like we talked about before. It's a function with a discrete domain.
Yeah.
Where the domain is just like, which row are we on? Which figure are we on? Like, well, we can just write these sequences arbitrarily. We can say 5, 9. What would be the next number if this was the same, like a linear type 13. Of sequence?
13. Then
13.
17. Then 21.
Because how much is it going up by?
4.
That's the first thing. That's the first thing that you notice with the rows is that it goes up by a certain amount.
Yeah.
This guy right here. This is an arithmetic. Spelled the same as arithmetic.
Oh, arithmetic.
It's so arithmetic.
Why do you say it different?
Is like red.
Because it's
because
two
now it's an adjective and not a noun. The longer you guys make us all wait, the longer we're gonna go into lunchtime. Please, just listen for a second. No, you don't. Who thinks Kyle's a good listener and not a good talker?
All I'm ever done is her hand.
Do not raise your hand.
Sam, keep it down.
He doesn't
know how. I put it together with not talking. Okay, so this thing in an arithmetic sequence is a special name. It's called a common difference. What does difference usually mean?
Difference between how many.
Subtraction.
Not
the same as. Yes, subtraction in mathematics, right? Difference in mathematics, it's subtraction. How do I use subtraction to find the common difference?
You minus.
You minus.
Well,
You subtract two different numbers.
9 minus 4. 5.
4.
4. 5.
5.
Oh, 5.
9 minus 5 gives me 4.
Yes.
Yeah.
4 is the common difference.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I could also call the common difference. What else could I call the common difference? If we're talking about functions.
Rate of change.
Rate of change. We're talking about a graph.
Linear
rate of change.
What if we're talking about the graph? The rate of change translates to
the
what
slope.
On the graph?
The
slope. Okay, so we know all about arithmetic sequences. We just didn't know we knew about them.
I did actually know about them.
Okay, goodbye, have a good day.
You too, peace out.